is Patrick Ehoman, and I am the founder of the HEPA organization. I'm here to raise funds for this woman, Madam Ariana Stella Maris. Look at her leg condition. This woman is dying. Last time we met this woman, it was when my team went to meet her in Lagos at Yanaodo. One of her leg was swollen. You know, but now you can see it's affecting two of her legs. This woman is dying. And you are out there. She's an Asian woman. You are out there. Little is enough. What we are asking for is collaboration. You know, we cannot do it all by ourselves. We have a lot of things, a lot of courses that we are trying to do. And we need your help to actualize these courses. We need your donation. We need your support to be able to accomplish these missions. We have so far tried our best. We have spread our tentacles. We have tried to cover all we can cover. But we need your support in this one. Look at this woman. Look at her condition. She is dying gradually. The doctor are demanding so high. You know, in Nigeria hospital these days, how much they charge? When the hospital will be charging you $250,000 for just treatment, scan, and all that, they'll be giving you so big. This woman, we will have give you her account to pay the money into you want to donate. But we want to see, as an organization, we want to utilize this money. That HEPA, we are known for credibility. We are known for fulfilling our promise. We are known for actualizing. We are known for using our resources to do the right thing. Like, we investigate properly. Every help we have rendered, we make sure we help genuinely. We don't just help, we help, we investigate, we make sure we help, and we utilize the money effectively. This woman, she's an Asian woman. She was attacked according to her story. Saying here now is she's dying from one leg to the other, and the leg is swelling rapidly as if it's going to burst. So this woman, she's in pain. She's in serious pain. You are out there as you are watching this footage. You know, I want you to do something to help this woman. We need money to help this woman. We need about 1 million, because this woman, she's homeless. She's living in unprotected a church. I can't call that accommodation. You know, look at where she's living, and she even drove her out of the place. She's homeless. She's homeless. She have no family. She have nowhere to go, and she's in pain with two of her legs. So let's help this dying woman, please. We are urging you to make donation to help this woman, to rescue this woman out of this situation. She is dying. Her name is Stella Ariarera Maris, and she's from Edo State. She needs our help. Whether you are from Edo State, you are Igbo, you are Yoruba, you are Hausa, we are not tribalistic. Please, we need your help. Help to support this woman, please. We are begging you in the name of God, in the name of whatever you believe in, to donate to help this woman, to rescue this woman from death. If you save someone's life, you know, you don't know how God can reward you abundantly. When you rescue people from this kind of state, God will never let you have a situation like this. God will never let you and your family have problems like this. So that is the advantage of helping. That is the advantage of sacrificing, of going the extra mile to make a donation. And little is better than nothing. That little we are saying is little, it can go a long way into this woman's life. Please help to donate to help this woman, to rescue this woman from this debt. Thank you all for your support, and thank you for your donation. And God bless you all.
My name is Joe. We are from the man behind this organization, the man who has been there for people, the man who has passion to help people. So please. said to us, yeah, we are here before, and he was touched by the scenario that he saw. So he asked us to come here and visit for the second time. Now, I'm meeting you for the first time here, although the other day Baba talked about you. So thank God we are meeting you here today, right? And can you please tell us a little about yourself?
But because of this attack,
so
we believe that I should change the direction to people. Because he said too much eyes out.
Alright.
So I feel now with the attack on this leg. This is a soil home to us. Really bad like this. But because I would have put them in the hole before now. So then we need to go and have a plantain.
Just
tell us
your name again, face the camera.
I am Mrs.
Oriana. Just tell us. Okay, from a good state. Wow, your condition is so complete.
That is
serious.
And because of this,
and I help, I think we need to walk very, very fast. Alright, I came here now to check on Madame Stella Maris. I can see what I saw was too shocking. Like, I don't even know what to say right now. This is the first leg that we saw the other time. And the thing now is affecting the second leg. Look at the second leg. Ah, this thing is too much. Even as much as the helper is trying to help us, trying to do something, government really needs to do something fast. Government really needs to come here and do something fast. Ah, look at her. Look at her. Oh my God. This is a woman that was working before, doing well for herself. All of a sudden, look at how she is right now. Ah. I think government needs to come fast. And the help, I think we need to work very, very fast.
So, ma'am, I want to know exactly what happened to you and why it happened.
Ma'am, I'm here with Mrs. Stella Maris. I want to get the details of how it all happened. And she has explained to us in her dialect. You understand? So now she's going to say it again in English for you to get it well. How did it
I just woke up in one morning, I saw my leg swollen. So as the little swollen, I didn't even understand. The man said that I stepped on something.
Wait, Madam Stella, you speak fluently, like you speak good English.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, that means you are educated.
Of course,
you are educated.
Yes.
You were working before,
right? Yes, in your world of
Mori Refinery. Did you hear that? She said she was working in Mori Refinery.
Blurring and forwarding. And mine, I was saying this fuel, control and all that. That is what I was saying. It was from there they attacked my leg. Because of this thing, they said because of this envy, I should leave the she leave the area. So from here, I will be able to have my assistant. That's what got me.
As in, from here, I don't know.
They said I should leave work to allow my mini eyes to leave because of fear envy. That is why they attacked us much. That is what made me leave a worry to
let us.
You know that these things go off my way. So I don't know that as I come to work, it's even the worst thing that what I was facing. Because every year, then they start attacking on this same day.
So, how you were saying something, how did this all happen? Now what do you want the help to be
able to make sure? As I woke up in the morning, I just saw my legs swollen into a reddish. They said, this is an attack. I stepped on something. So what am I seeing? Something. I went to the medical something. They said nothing. They cannot trace anything. So I said I use spiritual and medical for it, which I have been doing. I've been using the spiritual and medical for the said treatment. But upon all my effort and all that, something will go and start recording. Like the one that they attacked me recently, I know I spent almost a lot of money I have spent. I've sold all my property with respect to this. I've sold all what I
did. As in, you sold everything. Nigeria's government, can you hear this? This one really needs your help. By all means, anyhow you're going to do it, please. She needs your help. Please make haste in her case. Please make haste on her case. Don't allow her to. This offer is too much.
Because
the last time I came here, I noticed it was one leg.
No.
But now it's not the second leg.
So that is just why I said I beg you to render me assistance for me to go my spiritual. So at least I'll be able to save money to taking care of my daily feeding. Then maybe when God help me and deal with it, I'll be able to have a place to settle down, have an accommodation to be still.
Okay, accommodation. Talking about accommodation, where you are now?
This is a church.
Which church?
This is a place I'll be managing.
Right now?
Because of the stress I know. Because of this, when I was packing my things before, they said we should leave here. So now I'm not starting to manage this place for a long time. I'm able to get a stable place where I can put my head. That is just what I'm managing. This is not where I'm supposed to see. Where I'm putting my things. Brain has beaten everything. It's already gone.
So right now, no good health. No accommodation,
no money
to even eat,
no treatment,
nothing. So you are just, by the grace of God, wherever you see, you sleep. Oh, it's an interesting one. Trust me, God will send help.
Amen.
God will send it.
Amen. Helper has already come. Yes. Helper's organization. Yes. Bless God for
God. Yes, we bless God. So,
you make my life feel brand new.
From one leg to the other, and the leg is swollen rapidly as if it's gonna burst. So this woman, she's in pain. She's in serious pain. You are out there as you are watching this footage. You know, I want you to do something to help this woman. We need money to help this woman. We need about 1 million because this woman, she's homeless. She's living in unprotected. A church, I can't call that accommodation. You know, look at where she's living, and she didn't even drove her out of the place. She's homeless. She have no family. She have nowhere to go, and she's in pain with two of her legs. So let's help this dying woman, please. We are urging you to make donation to help this woman, to rescue this woman out of this situation. She is dying. Her name is Stella Maris, and she's from Edo State. She needs our help. Whether you are from Edo State, you are Igbo, you are Yoruba, you are Hausa, we are not tribalistic. Please, we need your help. Help to support this woman, please. We are begging you in the name of God, in the name of whatever you believe in, to donate to help this woman, to rescue this woman from death. If you save someone's life, you know, you don't know what, how God can reward you abundantly when you rescue people from this kind of state. God will never let you have a situation like this. God will never let you and your family have problems like this. So that is the advantage of helping. That is the advantage of sacrificing, of going extra mile to make a donation. And little is better than nothing. That little we are saying is little, it can go a long way into this woman's life. Please help to donate, to help this woman, to rescue this woman from this debt. Thank you all for your support, and thank you for your donation. And God bless you all.